getting late. I better get back. Ted'll be wondering where I am.
Oh, Ted, Ted, Ted. It's always Ted. What about my feelings?
He's my husband.
He's your husband in name only. You know it and I know it.
Can't we discuss this like adults?
Oh, you mean like your parents, who spent their entire married life living as strangers?
You sound like my brother Mark.
Mark, Mark, Mark. It's always Mark. What about my feelings?
Honey, you knew when we started this could never last. We both knew it.
Oh, darling, marry me. Say yes.
Oh, please, please don't torture me. You could never leave the kids. And Joyce? Joyce would die.
Joyce, Joyce, Joyce. It's always Joyce. What about my feelings?
Besides, I could never leave Ted. Not now. Not since the accident.
Never even knew you existed. And now that he's in a coma, he'll be even less interested.
He needs me.
He needs you. What about my feelings?
You're bitter.
Sure, I'm bitter. I have every right to be.
The man I fell in love with, the man I'll trade my husband for, would have understood.
I'm sorry. Just can't help it.
Maybe it was meant to be. Maybe we're just two ships that pass in the night.
Two ships that pass in the night? I feel like I'm in a B movie. Waiter, check, please. All right, no, that's it, that's it. Stop it. Hold the music. No, 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 it's ridiculous. No, I mean, I'm not going to go on with this thing. This is absolutely ridiculous. I was told when I came on the show that I would not have to work with the bees. And then now this is, and here they are. I was told no bees when I signed on to this. There's my big, dramatic chance to do something, and they stick a whole stage full of bees around me. Now, if you saw the first show, you saw with George Carlin, the bees did not work. And then the second show, with hosting, with Paul Simon hosting, the bees were horrendous. Now, I don't have to, how many times do I have to say it? I don't want the damn bees! Now, do you understand? Am I making myself clear? You're ruining the show. Will you please leave the stage?
Robbie, Robbie, Robbie. You don't have to be so hard on the bees. They just did it because they thought it would help the show.
But they're not helping the show. They're ruining the show. Honey, I don't need bees. I don't need bees. I'm a major star. I'm on the number one television show in America.
They're only bees.
I don't want the bees. What is it?
I'm sorry if you think we're ruining your show, Mr. Reiner. But, see, you don't understand. We didn't ask to be bees. You see, you've got Norman Lear and a first-rate writing staff. But this is all they came up with for us. Do you think we like this? No. No, Mr. Reiner. But we don't have any choice.
I don't know what to say. I feel terrible, but
I feel terrible.
You see, we were just like you were 5 years ago, Mr. Hollywood, California, number one show, big shot. That's right. We're just a bunch of actors looking for a break, that's all. What do you want from us, Mr. Rob Reiner? Mr. Star? What did you expect? The sting?
Well, I, for one, am totally embarrassed.
Still terrible. I thought I made myself perfectly clear that I didn't want the bees.
It's all right, honey.
Don't say honey.